Good morning, children. Welcome to the class of science. And in today's class, children, we are studying chapter number 2, that is health and hygiene. And here we are going to talk about the second topic, that is our hygiene. You will come to know all the major things which you should obey and follow to maintain good hygiene. So let us know, children, what do you mean by hygiene? And try to understand and have all those rules in mind for your good hygiene. Children, let us know. Hygiene is defined as the practice of staying clean to remain healthy and prevent diseases. So whereas hygiene is concerned, you must know that if you are having a practice of staying clean, what will be the main thing which you will get? Good health, as well as it will prevent any kind of disease around you. Clear? So let us know about all the major points which you should keep in mind and follow for good hygiene. First, children, we should have a bath daily. As you know, children, your body sweats. And when you are sweating, all the dust particles get stick to your body. And they can be forming any kind of germs on your body. So whenever, whichever day is starting, first thing what you need to do is, you have to have a bath in the morning. And if you are moving around at any such place which is dirty, after that also you must take care of your hands and your body parts whenever you are entering the house. You must wash your hands and your feet. So first thing which you should keep in mind that you will have a bath every day to maintain good hygiene. Second, children, wash your hands with soap and water before and after eating food and after going to the toilet. As these days, you have come to know that we are fighting with COVID-19. And everywhere you are seeing advertisements, and everywhere it has been talked about that one should always wash the hands with soap. So in all, you have to have a practice of always washing hands with soap and water before eating, because maybe you must be carrying some germs in your hands and that might enter your body. So if you are washing your hands with the soap, you might avoid any kind of disease. Come on. So you will try to obey this rule that you will wash your hands every time whenever you are starting to eat anything. Clear? And whenever you are coming after the toilet, properly you will wash your hands with the soap. Next point is, germs are also present in the soil. Since you are small, you would be likely to play in the soil. You must be going out on the playground to play. And you must be coming in contact with the soil. And you don't know the soil is carrying some or the other kind of germs. So make it a point, children, whenever you are playing in the soil, you take care of yourself. And take a proper bath, proper wash of your hands and feet before you enter the house. Clear, children? So that no germs can enter your body. Clear? Next point is, we should take proper care of our eyes and ears. These two things are very sensitive part of your body. And with the help of the eyes, you are able to see so many beautiful things around you. So must take care of your eyes and ears. The ears should be clean. Do not use any sharp object to clean your ear. Clear? Take help of your elders and take a proper checkup of your eyes regularly. And whenever you need to go to the doctor, get a proper checkup of your eyes. Clear? And even ears can be cleaned with the help of your elders. Do not try on your own to clean your ear with the sharp object. You must use the earbuds, and slowly and very softly you can just clean up the internal part of the ear. But do not try on your own. You must ask your elders to help you in this. Clear? And must see to it that you are having clean eyes and clean ears. Next, children, we talk about the point that is, we should brush our teeth twice a day. So children, once in the morning and once in the night before going to sleep. As you know, the food particles are sticking to your teeth and then they can form any kind of cavity, and those cavity is very painful. So one should always take care of the teeth by brushing twice a day. Then children, we must wash our hair regularly. As you know, if you are not washing your hair properly, you might get lice and you might get this kind of a thing which is very, very bad for the hair. So proper timingly you must wash your hair and keep them clean. Next children, we talk about, we must keep our surroundings. We must keep our surroundings clean by throwing garbage only in a dustbin. Keep our surroundings clean by throwing garbage only in the dustbin. That can be a covered dustbin. Clear? So that no disease is spread around you. You are keeping the surrounding clean, there would be never any kind of disease around your place. Then children, we talk about, we should ensure that water is not allowed to collect inside old tires, as collected water can become breeding ground for mosquitoes which spread diseases. As you know children, the mosquitoes, they breed on a particular area where the water is stagnant and it is collected at one place. Clear? So you should see to it that the water is never stagnant, it is always moving, and you should ensure that the water is not allowed to collect inside old tires. At times, you know, the old tires are around and then the water is just staying there for long, and then the mosquitoes come and breed on that water. So do not allow the mosquitoes to breed and spread any kind of disease around you. I hope children, with the help of this kind of points, these kind of points, you have come to know all about maintaining good hygiene, which is very essential for our body. If you are maintaining these points, if you are hygienic, never any kind of disease will come across you. So try to obey all these rules which I have told you, all these points, keep them in mind and try to follow to maintain good hygiene. Clear children? That's all for my class children, and just try to follow all these points which I have told you in my class today. So that's all for my class today. Thank you. Have a nice day. Bye bye for now. Take care.